One of the most outstanding things in the world is where one fights for their freedom.
Of course, wars may be fought with weapons, but they are won by men. It is the spirit of men who follow and the man who leads that gains the victory, George Putin once said.
The aggressiveness, the hope, the freedom lead to a revolution where people fight for their rights.
The 19th century is considered to be a rather outstanding era. It is the era where the Serbians, Albanians, Austria-Hungarians, and the Bosnians fought for their freedom against the almighty Ottomans.
Of course, the Serbian Revolution was one of the first revolutions in the Balkan Peninsula, but yet it was one of the most aggressive revolutions ever.
The revolution took place in Serbia, which is located in the Balkan Peninsula.
It took place from 1804 till 1813, and it took place again from 1815 till 1817.
The revolution happened twice, and in both times it was between the Serbians and the Ottomans.
The first revolution was led by Karadžorđe Petrović, who fought against the mighty Suleiman Pasha.
The second revolution was led by the Serbian prince Milos Obrenović against Marcel Ali Pasha from the Ottoman side.
The Serbians fought for their rights at gaining their independence.
That was due to nationalism and the mistreatment that the Serbians faced from the Ottomans. The Ottomans forced the Serbians to pay a large amount of taxes.
Of course, the Ottomans didn't want to lose Serbia due to its strategic place for trade purposes.
The revolution started by the Serbians winning constant and continuous battle against the Ottomans. The Serbians won battles like the Battle of Ikavik, the Battle of Misar, and the Battle of Deligrad.
The Serbians were able to establish a government that consisted between two groups, the socialist group and the rulers group.
Unfortunately, the Serbs were able to sustain their winning situation until the Ottomans were able to conquer Serbia. The Ottomans were able to conquer Serbia by using large amount of troops at once.
The first revolution failed and the second rose, with hope of seeking peace by a treaty.
Milos Obrenović rose to power seeking a treaty, but he wasn't able to achieve it until he showed the Ottomans that they needed the treaty more than the Serbs did. The Serbs won many battles under the ruling of Milos Obrenović, and that led the Ottomans to try and find a treaty between these two countries.
The Ottomans, of course, requested a treaty with the Serbs, allowing the Serbs to take advantage of the situation and building up an independent country. But the only problem that they need to pay a yearly tax for the Ottomans.
The Albanians rose against the Ottomans because they wanted their own freedom.
The revolution was between the Albanians and the Ottomans.
The Albanian revolts took place throughout the 19th century, specifically between 1833 and 1847.
The Albanian revolution consisted of three revolts, and each revolt had its own period of time.
The first revolt was from 1833 to 1839. The second revolt was from 1843 till 1844. The third revolt took place in 1847.
The Albanian Revolution was led by various leaders, but the most famous one and well known is Tafil Buzi, who was the leader for the most amount of battles during the revolt.
Of course, on the other hand, the Ottomans had important figures as well, but the most famous three were Hafez Pasha, Mehmet Pasha, and Omar Pasha.
The first Albanian revolt started because of nationalism and mistreat of the Ottoman, just like the Serbian revolution.
The second revolt started because the Ottomans arrested some Albanian locals, and that was a prime factor in the second Albanian revolt.
The third revolution has started when the Ottomans placed newer high taxes on the Albanians, leading them to seek again for their rights and their freedom.
Of course, the Ottomans did not want to hand the land to the Albanians, and that's due to the large amount of money they gained from that region. They got money from resources, businesses, and taxes that they forced on the locals.
The Albanians were clever. They used a strategy called War of Attrition, in which it enables them to prevent goods to be accessed to the Ottomans, allowing the Albanians to weaken the Ottomans.
The first uprising led to the win of the Albanians, which allowed them to gain rights and freedom, and they got control of the regions of Volar and Djevik, and that region marked the loss and retreatment of the Ottomans.
The second revolt led to the winning of the Ottomans after they killed the second uprising leader, Dervish Kara.
By that, the Ottomans placed large amount of taxes on the Albanians, which allowed them to increase their income.
This led the Albanians to uprise again, but due to artillery that the Ottomans had, the Albanians were destroyed, resulting in the loss of the Albanians.
The Bosnian Revolution happened in the Balkan Peninsula. The uprising took place from 1831 till 1833.
It was between the Ottomans and the Bosnian Ayans.
The leader of the uprising was the Bosnian general Hussein Gradozevic, and the Ottoman leader at that time was Mahmud II.
One of the main reasons that the uprising started was because of taxes.
The taxes made the Bosnian Ayan very angry, since they were losing money.
Of course, the Ottomans have their own reason, and one of the main reasons is that Bosnia is a strategic place for economic reason,
allowing the Ottomans to increase their businesses in the Balkan Peninsula and throughout Europe.
Of course, the Ayan raised an army that allowed them to gain an advantage over the Ottomans.
The Bosnians were able to successfully do their mission, and that allowed them to have some benefits from the situation.
The tax system was replaced. The people got their rights, and they simply got their freedom.
The Austria-Hungarian uprising started in 1878 and ended at 1908.
It was between the Austrians and the Ottoman Empire.
Of course, for every battle, there is a leader.
And the Austrian leader was called Joseph Philipp Fuch, and the Ottoman leader was Hafez Pasha.
The uprising took place in the western part of the Balkan Peninsula.
It starts because of nationalism, humiliation, and mistreat of the Ottomans.
The Ottomans On the other hand, did not want to lose Austria-Hungary, and that is due to economic reasons.
The uprising was taken to street fighting.
The Austrians were able to capture the Ottoman leader, Hafiz Pasha.
The uprisers were able to occupy Velet of Bosnia and Herzegovina thanks to the Treaty of Berlin.
Unfortunately, the uprising costed the life of 1,946 men and wounded 3,900 people.
The similarities.
I have noticed three common things that occurred in all the Balkan Peninsula revolts.
The first similarity is that the Ottomans wanted land in the Balkan Peninsula. Because of its strategic place, the Balkan Peninsula connects all three big continents and has a lot of trade routes. That's why the Ottomans really want the Balkan Peninsula because it serves economical purposes.
The second similarity is that all the revolts were against the new laws that the Ottomans placed in the Balkan Peninsula area. The Ottomans increased the taxes greatly, and that made people in the Balkan Peninsula rise up against them.
The third similarity is that all the revolts were a limited war. They are limited war because all of them were just between the Ottomans and a group of nations like the Serb or the Albanians. And it didn't involve whole the country, it just involved like part of the people.
The differences.
Most of the battles that happened in the Balkan Peninsula were straightforward. The Armenian revolts, on the other hand, were very different from other revolts in the Balkan Peninsula. Although there were some straightforward battles, but most of them were the same as war of attrition. In Albania, sieges and blockades were very common, and that is why the Albanian revolts were longer than the other revolts in the Balkan Peninsula.
The revolts in the Balkan Peninsula were fairly good for the people who lived in the Balkan Peninsula. An example of a good result of the revolts were the Serbs. The Serbs got their land from the Ottomans. The Albanians, on the other hand, were in the losing side at the end of the revolts. Although it were the longest the revolts in the region, the Albanians lost to the Ottomans when the revolts of 1847 were shut down by the Ottomans. So, not all revolts in the region were successful and rewarding.
Bosnia and Herzegovina changed from civil administrative country to military occupation.
The Bosnians fought with an army of 5,000 men.
Rapo Hekali, the Albanian leader, was killed by poison in the Ottoman jail.
The second Serbian uprising leader was nicknamed Prince of Serbia after he gained Serbia its independence back.